didn't know that I'd fall so hard. Then my feet left the ground.
To love is not to possess, to own or imprison, nor to lose oneself in another. Love is to join and separate, to walk alone and together, to find a laughing freedom that lonely isolation does not permit. It is finally to be able to be who we really are, no longer clinging in childish dependency, nor docilely living separate lives in silence. It is to be perfectly oneself and perfectly joined in permanent commitment to another and to one's inner self. Love only endures when it moves like waves, receding and returning gently or passionately, or moving lovingly like the tide in the moon's own predictable harmony. Because finally, despite a child's scars or an adult's deepest wounds, they are openly free to be who they really are and always secretly were. In the very core of their being, where true and lasting love can alone abide.
If you ever go to pieces, fall between the thunder.
Marriage is an amazing adventure. It's like a roller coaster ride, full of ups and downs, excitement, and a little bit of fear. You're about to embark on this wild journey together. So buckle up and brace yourselves. Remember, communication is key, especially when assembling furniture from IKEA. Nothing tests a relationship quite like decoding confusing instructions. But if you can make it through that, you can conquer anything. Laughter is essential in this lifelong partnership, because let's face it, life can be downright ridiculous. Find joy in the little things, like inside jokes and funny faces. And don't forget to celebrate the silliness that surrounds you. But among the laughter, there will be challenges. Arguments about whose turn it is to do the dishes, or who gets the last slice of pizza. Those are the real dilemmas. But remember, to go to bed with a hug and a smile, because life's too short to stay mad over the small stuff.
Marriage in this country means the union of two people, voluntarily entered into for life to the exclusion of all others. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Alex.
Why I, Alex.
May not be joined.
May not be joined.
In matrimony.
In matrimony.
To Sandra.
To Sandra.
And Sandra, your turn. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Sandra.
Why I, Sandra.
May not be joined.
May not be joined.
In matrimony.
In matrimony.
To Alex.
To Alex.
Sandra, when I first met you on that cold day in Brixton, I felt I might have finally found someone I could truly connect with. I know I may have came across slightly intense in those first exchanges, but I'm so glad I didn't scare you away. We dated for 6 weeks before we couldn't see each other for months, yet we spoke every day, which bonded our connection. And when we finally got to see each other, I unintentionally made you think I friend-zoned you. I was just a stickler to the 2 meter rule, but I would do it differently now. I would have kissed you that day. As things opened up, the first time we spent a few days together, that was a moment I realised something special and life-changing was happening. I just wanted to be with you all the time, and that feeling has never let up. When we got COVID that year, those were the best 2 weeks locked up in your place. I never wanted to leave, and I never did. And then I thought that I was dreaming when you said you loved me. I had no chance to prepare. I couldn't see it coming. And I wanted you to know that when I said it, I really meant it. I love you. I love your beauty. I love your confidence. I love how you can talk to anyone in a room with such ease. I love how kind and thoughtful you are. I love those spicy Korean noodles you cook. I love your smile. I love your laugh. I love your intelligence and opinions. I love your self-belief and your sense of adventure. I love you when you're happy. I love you when you're sad. I love you at 3 a.m. after a night out at Archer Street. I love being around you all the time. The last 3.5 years have been a dream. Thank you for bringing me into your life. Thank you for loving me. Thank you for making me smile and making me feel the luckiest man in the world. I promise to give you those same feelings back every day. I promise to love you unconditionally and have your back in every moment. I promise to encourage you to follow your dreams and live the most fulfilled life. I promise to stand by you and support you in challenges we all face. And I promise to celebrate you with all the joyous moments in life. I promise to make you smile every day. I promise to never let us lose our spark. I promise to make the pillows on the sofa. I promise to clean the bathroom. Occasionally. I promise to stop being such a grumpy old man, to ensure we have such happiness and sunlight in our lives as possible. But most of all, I promise to love you forever and walk this journey of life together, hand in hand.
On New Year's Eve of 2019, I remember counting down to midnight and wondering what 2020 would have in store for me. Little did I know it would be love and lockdown. From the moment our eyes met on that first date, I knew in my heart that you were meant to be mine. And now, as we stand here on our wedding day, I am overwhelmed with joy and gratitude. Looking at you right now, I know this is a big moment, but the truth is that with you, every day feels special. Today is one of a million memories that I intend to create beside you throughout our lives. We already treat each other with kindness, support, loyalty, and respect. We approach every day with trust. We lift each other up when we're down. So instead of writing a new list of commitments, today I vow to continue being your partner, your friend, your confidant, your teammate, just with a new title. Forever and always, I am yours.
Do you take Sandra for your lawful wedded wife, and do you promise to remain true to her for the rest of your lives together?
I do.
I do. I
love it. Having you near. You have made the declarations required by law and have made a solemn and binding promise to each other in the presence of your family, friends, and us, the registrars. Today is a new beginning in your continuing journey together, and we hope that the love you clearly have for each other will deepen and grow throughout the years to come. So it is with great pleasure and privilege for me to declare you are now husband and wife, and you may kiss.
The sun danced on the snow with a sparkling smile as two lovers sat quietly alone for a while. Then he turned and said, with a casual air, though he blushed from his chin to his hair, "I think I might like to get married to you." "Well then," she said, "there's a thought. But what if I can't promise to be all that we ought? Can you promise me, say, that you won't rage and shout if I'm late yet again when we plan to go out? For I know I can't promise I'll learn to ignore dirty socks or damp towels strewed all over the floor. So if we can't vow to be all that we should, I'm not sure what to do, though the idea is quite good." But he gently smiled and tilted his head till his lips met her ear, and softly he said, "I promise to weave my dreams into your own, that wherever you breathe will be my heart's home. I promise that, whether with rags or with gold I am blessed, your smile is the jewel I will treasure the best. Do you think then, my love, we should marry, do you?" "Yes," she smiled, saying, "I do."
Give you the best of me.
Amazing.
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 Ooh.
Having you close to me.
Having you close to me.
Amazing.
Amazing.
Outrageous.
Oh.
Sandra. I'm a very proud mom today. Oh, yeah, you marry the man you love and care for. And obviously there's ups and downs in relationships, but as long as you discuss and come to an agreement. And parents were all there, friends to guide, give advice, wherever you need it, okay? And as Sandra was growing up, I can honestly say we never had any major issues. She was organized, focused, knew what she wanted to do. So we never had any problems. I guess we were just lucky. So, wish you a happy marriage. You've started your journey in your marriage. Wish you well. And hopefully you learn along the way, but we're always here to give advice. So thank you, everyone. Okay, all right.
The day Sandra was born, I happened to be still in the university. So when I left the university, I came and found the beautiful lady that is now bringing us together. I remember I used to come every weekend to spend night with Sandra, to spend the time with Sandra. I would hold her in my chest, lie in my bed, talk to her. She didn't understand, but it was quite a memorable time. The feeling of holding Sandra to my arms was satisfying. My late mother gave her the name Lamaro. Lamaro means love. So Sandra, we love you.
Hi everyone. It's an absolute honor to be standing here today with my drink. As Sandra's maid of honor. There's a time in every single woman's lives when they meet the love of their lives. And for Sandra, that was 16 years ago when she met me. But if someone else have to spend the rest of their lives with Sandra, I'm glad the person is you, Alex. I've had the pleasure of knowing the stunning bride since we were 18, 19, when we used to work in a nightclub in Norwich. We've shared a lot of great memories together. A lot of tears, a lot of laughs, and the kind of memories that we'll store forever. So when Sandra asked me to do this speech today, I said no. But obviously, I said yes in the end. I asked her to go out for dinner with me, and I shared a list of different stories that I wanted to share with all of you today. Sandra got her phone out in a restaurant, and we were looking through the menu. I wasn't really sure what she was doing, but she got her Google Translate out in a menu that was already in English. Or like the time when we were at a bar in Soho in Archer Street, which Alex mentioned in his speech, but I won't really go into it because Sandra has absolutely no to this story. But that involves tequila and my shoes. And that's when she realized tequila is not really her friend. And then there's also a time where she spent Christmas with me and Flo right after she met Alex. She spilled a whole glass of red wine all over this cream sofa. She panicked and caught Alex. That was actually the first time that Flo met Alex over this little dramatic moment. But I won't go into too much story because Sandra was actually very embarrassed about that. But I would just say that Varnish fabric spray is absolutely magical, and that definitely saved my friendship with both Sandra and Flo. We've been friends ever since. If you know Sandra, you would know that she's not great a navigator. Both me and her are not great. So now let's talk about Sandra and Alex as a couple. They say that opposites attract. And I guess that statement is true. Alex loves his spreadsheet and his finance, very good with money. Sandra, not so much, but it's getting a little bit better. And Sandra is a fantastic dancer. Alex, not so much, but it's getting a little bit better. And despite some of the differences, they complement each other in the most remarkable ways. They both have unique qualities about them, resulting in a partnership filled with love, laughter, and just the right amount of well-intentional chaos. Sandro, I'm very happy that you found a person you can navigate life with, even though I know you're pretty terrible in that in life. Your second best friend, your husband, and a partner in life all in one. And thank you for always being there for me. You're one of the funniest, kindest, and most loyal people I know. And I'm so grateful to have you in my life. Alex, you're a perfect match for Sandra. I've never seen her so smitten and happy with anyone else. You make her so happy, so thank you. Little did I know you would become such a dear friend to me after meeting you for the first time in 2020, just before COVID started in Brixton. Not only have you won over Sandra's heart, but you have also won me over. One of the things that I love about you the most is you would always welcome me with a huge hug and a big glass of Prosecco at your door whenever I come around. I also want to thank you for accepting me as your third wheel, always letting me just invite myself over and to all of your dates. And thank you for taking me as part of this package too. It's been a privilege to watch both of your love story unfold. So here's to Sandra and Alex, two extraordinary individuals who have found the perfect match in each other. It's my privilege to be part of your next chapter as a married couple. May your life together be a beautiful blend of love, adventure, and creating more memories. This is just the beginning of your love and forever together. So now stand and raise your glass. Here's to Sandra and Alex.
Everyone, my wife and I. I said my wife and I want to welcome you to the best wedding of our lives. My wife and I are grateful you are all here. My wife and I are happy the people we love the most in the whole world are in the same room at the same time. My wife and I are so grateful to you all for traveling vast distances and time zones to spend the most important moment of our lives together so far. My wife and I love saying that. My wife and I are so grateful for all of your help, support, contributions to make this day possible. We love you all. Thank you so much for everything. And this day is going so quickly, but we will cherish it forever. Agnes and Stephen, thank you so much for raising this perfect woman who has become my wife. Without both of your love and guidance and discipline, she would not be the woman she is today. We want to thank you both for everything you have done, your unbelievable support, helping us pulling this family together as well to organize this day. Thank you for welcoming me into your family. And I'm so excited to officially be part of it now. Michael, thank you so much for your kind words and the upcoming song that we have. I don't know if everyone picked up on that earlier, but the song that he played and he danced onto, which I decided I'm not gonna do a dance for my speech, is it's a song he got made in Uganda, and if you listen carefully, you can hear Sandra and I's name in the song and our parents' names. And I believe there's a part two remix. Thank you for welcoming me into your side of the family. Thank you for your support, and thank you for traveling afar. It's great for us to spend this valuable time together. We'll take the advice on board and lean on family to help us on this adventure. For the whole of Sandra's family, since day one, you have made me feel part of the family. And I'm so excited to spend and have so many more memories like this together with you all.
Thank you all for bringing this beautiful day together. Now on to my family. I just want to say thank you to my dad. I think you've played a massive part in for me becoming the person I am today. You gave me a very strong work ethic. You gave me confidence to kind of speak with people in public. I'll always cherish, I think my favorite memories with you are always gonna be listening to 60s music in the restaurant. Whenever I hear something from the restaurant, it just takes me back to those days. Joe, I want to say a massive thank you to you as well. You've treated me and Owen as if we were your own. And you're an absolute bedrock to the family, and we love you so much. So thank you for everything that you've done for us. And to the rest of my family as well, my grandparents, my aunties, I just want to say thank you for all the years that you've helped us and supported us. But probably my favorite person in the world, if it's not Sandra, is my mum. I think you're like the best person in the world. Everything that you've done and sacrificed for me and Owen, you always put us first. You made sure we had everything. You gave us independence and freedom to do what we needed to do, to make mistakes and learn from them. You're always the life of the party. My friends never used to ask me if they could stay at the house. They always went to you, even when I didn't want them there. Like, my friends loved you as well. And I know that everyone that meets you thinks you're incredible. So thank you for everything you've done for us. Oh, Wayne, where's O Wayne? Where is he? He keeps moving. Where? Hey, Owen. Owen, I just want to say, yeah. I just want to say, mate, I might be the older brother, but I look up to you. Yeah, that's good. And Tom. But honestly, mate, I'm so proud of everything that you've achieved, and I always look for your guidance and your opinion on things. And I think we always, being at that kind of age gap, we probably didn't get on very well when we were teenagers. And when we've spent more than a week together, we always end up fighting. But the 5 weeks that we spent together in Vietnam just made me realize that you're one of my best mates. So thank you for everything you've done. To the bridesmaids, thank you for ensuring Sandra turned up today. You look incredible, and honestly, you're the greatest friends that I've seen someone have. You're like incredible, and thank you so much for everything. In particular, Mandy, I've never come across a friend that's so thoughtful and just goes out of her way all the time for Sandra. Like, Sandra's so lucky to have you in her life. And I'm so grateful to have you in my life as well. She's a keeper, Niall. To my groomsmen, thank you for just some of the best memories I've had in my life with you all. Some great times at university and kind of in our adult life. Particularly, shout out to Kyle. We were inseparable as teenagers. And then 19 years ago, you left me. And the biggest sadness of my life is that we've not spent any of our adult life together. And I was so honored when you asked me to be your best man, and I was straight over there to just be with you on that special day. And I'm so grateful that you came all the way over here after not seeing you for 8 years to be by my side. It's been great having you here, Carl. I'll never forget it because we both now have matching tattoos on our left thighs. I might get it out on the dance floor later. And then to the two best men, Ralph, you've been there for me for 20 plus years, I think. You and Jess have let me third wheel for so long, and I'm so happy that I don't have to third wheel anymore. But honestly, thank you for everything, mate. Like, you always, if there's anything I ever need, I always know I can come to you and Jess. And I love you both. Jitesh, we have some incredible memories together. Most of them are not repeatable, although you might hear some of them. The ones that we might hear is, oh, okay, I had a heart-to-heart with my mum a couple nights ago. I told all my worst parts, so you don't need to divulge those. But honestly, mate, thank you for stepping up as well and being a best man alongside Ralph. You boys gave me exactly what I wanted from a stag do. I didn't appreciate the 6 a.m. kidnapping, but I was actually relieved when I saw the Jerry Well outfit, by the way, because I thought it was going to be a little bit more revealing. So, but honestly, I had the best time, and I'm so glad that you pulled everyone together for it. So I'm going to hand over to the best men so they can do their speech now. And Jit, I'm giving you free range to let rip, because Jay's wedding is in 3 weeks, and I am not going easy on you. So give it your best shot. Whoa. But of course. Sandra, I am so, so lucky that I came across you. I don't know how many of you know, but Sandra and I met on Bumble. And on Bumble, when you make a match, the woman has to go first. And she only has 24 hours to say hi, and if she doesn't, it's gone forever. So I'm so grateful that you said hi to me, and we went out on that first date in Brixton. I could just feel something was really special about to happen from then. And I honestly feel like I found someone who's just like me. We have so much in common. I just love spending every minute with you. When you go out on an evening with Mandy, I get bored at home. I literally sit there and do nothing. I can't even watch TV because I want to watch it with you. I want to watch these shows with you. But you're my best friend. You're the most beautiful person in the world. You make me feel incredible, the best version of myself. And this is just the beginning. We have so many exciting things ahead of us, and I love you from the bottom of my heart, and thank you for everything. So thank you all for coming today, and Sandra would like to say a couple of words as well, would you?
Yeah, just so very, very, very brief. I just wanted to thank my mum again, because without her, this would have been so hard to put together. I mean, she brought... She was so instrumental in getting the family involved and getting the guests from Uganda involved and Norway, and we would have found it so hard to invite so much of our family, because our family's huge, and so yeah, she really, really supported us and helped us every step of the way, and we wouldn't have this wedding without you. And I also want to thank Stephen. He's my stepdad, yeah. And he's been there since I can't even remember a time without you in my life, so thank you both.
It's amazing to see so many family and friends here for Alex and Sandra's wedding. Sandra, you do look breathtaking. Even Beyonce would be jealous. And Alex, well, Alex looks like Alex, and God loves a trier. Right, so they say a speech can be embarrassing, it can be funny, it can be warm. But the truth is, neither Ralph or I are any good at speeches, so we have no idea why he's allowed us to do this. And let's hope Sandra still wants to be married to you at the end of it. Ralph?
Thanks, Jay. And look, I think you nailed that, because God must love a trier, and God only knows how Saki's landed Sandra. So look, I hope everyone's having a good night. We know everyone's having a good night. I would also like to take this opportunity to apologize for my dancing earlier. That's a real no-no for me, but I did it for you, and that's it. That's the only time it's gonna happen. Right, let's get into a story about Alex. So, Alex and I have been friends since secondary school, and we shared a few classes together. We were in the same friendship group. We did literally everything together. But where I got to know him really well was on the football pitch. We used to play for the same football team, And it probably wouldn't surprise you to know that he was one of the most vertically challenged players on that football team. But what that did mean is everyone knew he was also one of the bravest, by the way he used to fly into a lot of those tackles. But that was one good quality. He's also really loyal. He's always got people's back. He's determined but fair in everything he does. And he brings a sense of adventure and a bit of humour to all his little stories.
Alex is funny, but he's also smart. Now, looking at him, you might not think it, and like many of you in this room, it really caught me off guard too. But it's true, he might be one of the smartest people I know. I've seen this guy ace exams whilst ill. I've seen him learn to code whilst he travelled across Australia. I've even seen him discover what my PIN number was whilst we're on a night out and save us from a 5-mile walk. So at some point, I was convinced Alex was like the Rain Man. But above all else, I think Alex is a passionate person. Now, Alex is the kind of person that he says things with such a passion, whether it's traveling, whether it's listening to music, or whether it's falling in love. He's always both feet in. And since meeting you, Sandra, I've seen Alex happier than ever before. I know when he talks about you that he's found his perfect partner in crime, and he feels the luckiest man in the world to have found you. So for about a decade, it's always felt like Alex and Jay. And I guess now it's gonna be Alex, Jay, and Sandra?
I'm not sure who the third wheel is there. I don't know, Sandra, how you feel about that one either. But look, in all seriousness, I think Jay mentioned this at the top. It's been a real honor having you as a mate, both of us, genuinely. But it's also been a real pleasure getting to know Sandra. You're a beautiful soul. And doesn't she look amazing in this dress today? Look, Sandra, Alex, you're both kind, loving, and fun. People like you are really rare, and you make a really good team. We're all humbled and grateful in this room to be here to share your special day, and we hope it's been everything you've ever wanted. So everyone, please join us in standing for a toast and raise your glasses as we all wish this amazing couple many happily married years ahead. To Sandra and Alex.
Amazing! Picture MJ on the sheet, thriller, funny vibes every night. Enter.